For most people, this is their largest financial instrument. Now, there's some super wealthy, but that's not my client base. I work with normal people. For my people, it's a big deal. They see that 30 years on the paperwork at closing, and you've seen the blood drain out of their face when it's like 2049 is your last payment. And they're like, because it's a long way away. And they're like, I'm borrowing $150,000. And there's a reality that sets in that the realtors, until they figure out that gap between licensure and knowing what they're doing, they're advising somebody in that really big space without knowing what they're doing. And knowing the laws doesn't make you competent, and it doesn't make you relatable or make it where you can create understanding on the part of the buyer or seller. And in real estate training, we tend to send people out and say, just go figure it out. And if you have a question, call us. And we are training our new realtors on the backs of the consumer. And what's even worse is, you think about it this way, new realtors come in, where do we send them out? Who do we have them work with, buyers or sellers?
Generally, they're going to work with the buyer.
Correct. We send them out as buyer's agents. Go work with some buyers. Here's some leads. Here's some open houses. Go work with buyers. But ask yourself this question. When do people make money on a house? When they buy it or when they sell it?
Oh, people, we make money on the house when we sell it.
That's the results of what happened when you bought it.
Well, I know the buyer funds the deal.
But when you buy a house.
Yes, when I bought the house.
That purchase decision, you're making money based on your buy decision, not based on your sell decision.
I got you. Okay, I got you.
I didn't word it correctly, but you think about it. It's that time at the buy when you have to be giving the correct advice on market value, structuring the deal properly, giving good advice based on what's happening with roads, what's happening with schools, what's happening with laws and regulations and zoning. All those things add up on the buy side. And we've all seen this. You go to sell somebody's house 5 years from now, they made an awful decision because they didn't get correct advice when they bought. And I say all that to drive home the point that when we take a new realtor out and hand them buyers, and especially if they're first-time buyers, they're very vulnerable. They don't know what's going on. And you've got the blind leading the blind. But the realtor doesn't pay the price in 5 years or 7 years when it's time to sell. It's the consumer that does.